and welcome to my Soul Tribe. My name is Miriam Rose. Today's video is about Trisha Paytas and her being in trouble. Before we go any further, if you wish to expand your consciousness, please visit my second channel called Spiritual Destiny. And now I'd like to say a word to Nick Snyder from The Viewer's Voice. He's going through a very difficult time in his life. My heart goes out to you and to your fiancé Dustin Daly. If you would like to reach out, by all means, do. I also lost my mother at the same age as you are now in very tragic circumstances, so I can relate and I feel so bad for your suffering at this time in your life. And now let's begin with the video. Thank you. Today we're talking about Trisha Paytas and how she's in trouble about all her lies. Basically, her subscribers have had enough of her trolling, and also she claims that she's in trouble from Ethan Klein's subscribers, but according to Ethan Klein, he has 2 million subscribers, whereas Trisha Paytas is getting in trouble by 5 million subscribers, so there's a discrepancy there. In any case, let's begin. Ethan Klein from Off the Rails, H3 podcast, did a video quite recently where he exposed Trisha Paytas for many of her lies. I watched the whole video so that you don't have to if you don't have the time. The backstory: Trisha Paytas is currently engaged to Moses, who is Ella's brother. Ella is married to Ethan Klein and also sits on the podcast of H3H3. Ethan Klein and Trisha Paytas used to do a podcast together called Frenemies. However, the show stopped due to their falling out. H3H3 got suspended for a week because Keemstar from Mom's Basement podcast complained to YouTube and the CEO of YouTube. As he stated, his complaint was not official, but it was on Twitter and it was directed at YouTube and its CEO, Susan, about Ethan playing inappropriately with a puppet which resembles Keemstar on Ethan's podcast. Trisha Paytas did many videos on Keemstar, expose videos, in fact. In an outrage that Keemstar, aged 39, was dating a 20-year-old. And she stated that people's frontal lobes don't get fully developed until the age of 25. Hence, there was an imbalance of power between Keemstar, who was 39 and still is, and his then-girlfriend, aged 20. Now, Keemstar and Ethan Klein are also arch enemies. Trisha stated in the past that she will never go on Keemstar's podcast as she despises him. Yet as soon as Ethan Klein got a 1-week suspension and Keemstar immediately invited Trisha Paytas on his podcast, she agreed instantly. The podcast, Mom's Basement, was cut short. It was only 30 minutes long, where Trisha was rushed out the door and Gabby Hanna was then ushered in for an interview. However, Trisha Paytas and Gabby Hanna are arch enemies. It was later said that Keemstar used Trisha Paytas for views and hype. Trisha claimed to have come onto Keemstar's podcast to roast him, yet she was pleasant, laughed and giggled all the way through, and was very friendly to Keemstar and his girlfriend, who is 20 years old, although they have recently broken up. Keemstar and his girlfriend broke up since the podcast, but at the time of the podcast, Trisha Paytas, who came on claiming that she is going to be roasting this relationship, was nothing but smiles. At Keemstar's podcast, while Ethan was suspended for a week, Keemstar took a photo of flipping off Ethan sitting next to a smiling Trisha who was wearing a Frenemies hoodie. Ethan stated that this was betrayal by Trisha on a whole new level. He stated this on his Off the Rails episode number 8 podcast. The podcast is called I'm Done with Trisha Paytas. Ethan's only statement was, "This really makes me sad." Trisha's response to Ethan was making 27 TikTok videos about Ethan, a 42-minute video about him, and 51 tweets about him. She was saying that Ethan was playing the victim and that he was lying, that he runs a cult of his followers and his fans are harassing her. However, in actual fact, the majority of Trisha's own fans have had enough of her lies and manipulation, as well as constant trolling, and have turned against her. Her latest videos, likes to dislikes ratio, is enormous, with about 4-to-1 dislikes to likes. Ethan's mom Donna, who has done 10 families episodes with Ethan, tweeted, "Can't wait to go to the wedding." Not meaning that she won't go to Trisha's and Moses' wedding because of Trisha's betrayal by going to Kim Starr's podcast. Trisha made numerous tweets and videos stating that Donna was evil because she messaged Moses a horrible message. Trisha stated that after that message and the tweet, Donna was uninvited to the wedding anyway. Donna addressed the message on the final Families episode. All she said was that if Ela happens to get a miscarriage, as Ela is pregnant at the time, so if she has a miscarriage because of all the stress that Trisha has placed on her, it will be their, meaning Trisha and Moses' fault. She followed with, "Stop this nonsense now." That was the entire message, and Ethan stated that Donna's message stated what he and everyone else were thinking. Just as a side note, Trisha followed Kim Starr on Twitter 2 hours after H3H3 podcast had been suspended for a week. Let's get on with Trisha's lies. Here is what Trisha said a few months ago about Kim Starr. She wanted to deplatform Kim Starr because Kim Starr didn't believe Jake Paul's accuser on SA. Just recently, Ethan told Trisha that he bets that as soon as Frenemies will end, she will run to Kim Starr and will do an interview with him. In response, Trisha swore black and blue that she would never do that, yet she did, in a flash, do just what Ethan predicted. Trisha kept asking, how did all of this get so much out of proportion? Yet she is the one who has been constantly roasting Kim Starr, calling him a creep and a lowlife, then doing a 180 and running on his podcast as soon as he invites her, only to roast Ethan Klein for most part of the Mom's Basement podcast run by Kim Starr. On to another subject. Trisha told Ethan that her ex-partner, Jason Nash, with whom she had a very difficult relationship, and his friend, David Dobrik, whom Trisha absolutely despises, just handed her a Pomeranian puppy without consulting her first, and how she never wanted a puppy in the first place. Then there are lots of clips and videos where Trisha talks about planning for this puppy and wanting the puppy, which, by the way, she swiftly gifted to her sister. This Pomeranian is no longer a puppy, yet he is still not potty trained and is still wearing diapers. Pretty bad, isn't it? On another note, as it turns out, Trisha, her fiancé Moses, who is Ethan's brother-in-law, have secretly recorded the last episode of Frenemies. And Trisha was just about blackmailing Ethan by stating that she will release this episode. Ethan chose not to air this podcast as the majority of his subscribers asked him not to air it. they just didn't want any more rifts between Ethan and Trisha. Ethan, who records at home, later on stated that he found it to be a huge violation of having been secretly recorded in his own house by his own family, meaning Trisha and Moses. In my previous video, I will leave the link below. Feel free to watch it. I stated that I don't believe that Trisha has schizophrenia. Sure enough, she has just come out with a video and stated on her podcast called My Chemical Imbalance that she is self-diagnosed and that she doesn't have schizophrenia. Whereas in her previous videos, she swore that she was diagnosed with the disorder by a doctor, a psychiatrist for that matter. I guess it's difficult to believe someone who spends so much of her time on telling lies that she forgets them herself, just as well that they have all been recorded. As a side note, does anyone else find it difficult to understand what Trisha says? Some people claim that she talks really fast when she is anxious. I'm just wondering what you think. Please comment below and let me know on your thoughts. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate each and every one of you. Please make sure to subscribe. Please like the video and also comment below. Engagement is very important to me and I love getting to know your opinions. And also, don't forget to follow me on Twitter, on Instagram, as well as TikTok. Thank you once again. Cosmic kisses to everyone. Till next time. Bye for now.